Oh, excuse me. It's the Wickersham Leaders Show with today's episode, Monkey Mania. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello, hello once again. Welcome back to the Wickersham Leaders Show. On today's episode, we are going to be doing Super Smash Fridays. You guys love it.
I hope you do anyway.
But just like all other weeks, I'm going to give it some time to stew with some practice from, with the training mode. Flabbergasted if that title hasn't appeared before. I don't claim to have 100% original titles. I mean, look, I stream 6 days a week. I'm gonna repeat some. The question is, how long has it been since I've used that? Because I'm 100% certain I've used that one before. Excuse me. And yes, I don't have my Halloween music ready, but I forgot to go through it and make sure that it's up to date and it's got everything I want in it and it has all the things I don't want in it out. So you'll have to bear with me for a little bit. Regardless, I need to get some practice in before we begin, you know, to really stretch my limbs around. Jeez. There we go. Oh, well, excuse me. Gosh, no, I shouldn't be yawning. I just started No, don't yawn. We just got here. Oh, that's embarrassing. No, don't do classic mode. We were going to training. I'm gonna tell you, Smash feels very different when you don't have a new character or something to look for. Make the tune sleeping noise when you sleep? Well, it depends. There's a few. Sleeping stream when? Sure, we'll do a sleeping stream. This is stupid. This bit isn't going anywhere. Wow, it just gave me K. Rool, huh? I should have Pit instead. I kind of want to play DK. But I need to keep playing Diddy because I have to get the experience. Stream running accidentally exposes that he's animated in Korea. Oh no! And here's me not knowing any Korean! Wow, I really can't make it back from that. I wish I had better... I need to know some better starter combos. It's a joke that kids would never get in Steven Universe, but I appreciated it. Right. I forgot that episode. You know, it used to be that they would outsource them to Japan. In the 80s and 90s, Japan really wanted to be seen as like a center for that sort of thing. They thought it brought good business. But they do their own thing now. And now Korea's cheaper, so they go to South Korea. Mm. What's a good percentage for this combo to work the best at, now that I'm looking at it? Ah! I'm just trying to reposition Ness. I keep going to the right. I was trying to do it without damaging him. Ugh. I really hope that today I'm gonna be able to do something. Oh yeah, rolling behind him. The fact that a dash attack into another move works pretty well at most percents is nice, but it's such a nothing combo. I'm not getting anything off of it. Yeah. But I can't really find any better ways to consistently get that damage out, you know? Like, if I try to do one of the banana things, well, now they're shielding, and if I can't tell you how many times I've tried to go for this, and it just hasn't worked. I still need to figure out better kill options. Because I can't just keep relying on... I can't just keep trying to go for a smash attack. But right now, I can't find any better way to do it. Because nobody ever falls for the banana peel anymore. Like, it takes so long to get somebody to be hit by the banana peel by the time they've been hit by it, I'm not in the advantageous position to use it. Is Diddy's Nair bad? I don't think it's bad. But it's small. And it's outside of the range I generally want to be at with Diddy. I don't really want to be in someone's face. I want to be like here. Assuming that they're not spamming projectiles. What's going on out there? There's some flippin' lawn equipment going on outside. Great. And it's causing the flippin' coyotes to bark all over. Diddy seems like he would need to be in somebody's face. If I'm trying to use banana peel, I don't want to be in their face. Because being in their face just makes it all that easier for them to, like... Just makes it all that easier for them to, like, see it coming. I don't know. I don't ever want to be close to people when I'm playing Diddy. I don't like being close, because if I'm close, then I'm small. You know, like, that's the easiest way for them to hit me is if I'm close. I'm not even practicing anything. I'm just kind of messing around here. The only thing you can do from a distance is banana throw or monkey flip. Two options is very predictable. Yeah, I don't know. Well, I can also peanut pop gun. Nair is pretty good for combos and advantage day, but that's about it. You gotta be very comfortable with Z-dropping and re-catching bananas with aerials to utilize Nair well, though. Well, dropping it with Nair is actually a lot easier than trying to use a different one. I'm gonna pull Diddy out for a match or two just to feel. Okay. I can't, oh my gosh, the equipment outside and the barking is so loud. Did they have to start now? I'm seeing it on the microphone. It's being picked up a lot. Gosh, like, they started, like, immediately after I did. You don't hear it. Well, if you guys aren't hearing it, then it's not that big of a deal. But I can see it's being picked up by the mic. Guess I also need to practice recovery. Because a lot of the times, Diddy can't really... I don't know how to describe it, but a lot of the times, Diddy just can't make it back. Like, it's funny, I feel way less in control of my recovery with Diddy than with DK. Police activity in your neighborhood last night. What were they doing? They found out I'm torrenting 70s anime. Oh my gosh. Illegal, illegal. I guess these are more so exercises to limber up my fingers than anything productive. Whatever. I never do know what I actually should practice anyway. You always have Z drop banana into down air as a confirm to catch low recoveries. So you mean like catching the banana again? Well, this is gonna go well. That didn't go very well. You Z-drop the banana and let it hit where the opponent will be, and then you confirm it into a down air. So, like, you Z-drop the banana as a bluff? So, like, I Z drop the banana to, like, get them to go a different way, and then I... Oh, so it just works when my opponent does it. Right, okay.
Oh gosh, it's getting louder. Why did they have to start right now? Why are you doing this right now?
Okay, I think they've stopped, or at least slowed down. But it's pretty telling that Zelrog being, yeah, I'm gonna see what Diddy can do, is on par with me, who's actually trying to, like, learn how Diddy works. Like, his day one Diddy is the same as my, I used to play him a lot and now I'm coming back to him Diddy. And these matches keep ending up being close. So I'm not really all that skilled with him. Wow, that worked? Wow, he won? For Pete's sake. That should have been in the bag. Those first two stocks were so easy. If I was just more consistent at getting, nice Diddy, thanks, I suppose.
If I was just more consistent at getting him off stage, just grabbing. Or if I had more of a stage where I could run away and be annoying, that would be great too. Nice reversal on the kick. Oh, wow, you missed? A little surprised that that kick didn't count as using, as breaking the KO punch off. Gosh, I can't keep them quiet. What? That no. Nuh-uh. You were out, I mean, if it killed you when you were off stage, not when I was above the stage, and it launched me so far to the right that I fell off. I should have hit the ground. Besides, you're Little Mac. You need to suck with how good your attacks are. Thank you.
I just there's no way to fight Mac that doesn't feel like pulling teeth, even if you're winning. Another Mac, huh? Iron Mac? You know who this person is? Is it another little Mac? I hope not. Because I don't know if I want to fight a bunch of little Macs. Ruthless little Mac. Well, guess I can say goodbye to my winning prospects then. I don't even want to try to win, if I'm totally honest. Because I know it's just going to be horrible even if I do. See what I mean? Once Mac knows what you're doing, it becomes a long exercise in patience and oh my gosh. That weak recovery, quote-unquote, that Mac has isn't so weak these days. So there's no real way to just gimp him. Hit him out of Haymaker. Yeah, but then I have to have Banana, and usually he's only off stage because I've managed to use Banana.
I don't know how to, like, stop Mac from doing what he wants to do. You can't really interrupt his attacks. Shielding them is a bad idea since he's got very easy shield breaks on his super fast smash attacks. Trying to go for a grab is just a death sentence. And if I try to use a projectile, he can kind of just maneuver around them. Well, that's the rotation. So you should, you have to go to the back now. Because now we have four? Yeah, the rotation's in effect. Oh, I'm gonna die. Well, on this stream, you're not really gonna, I don't know if you're gonna find anybody of their caliber here. I should be doing much better with Diddy, but... Hello, Puggy. I'd love to answer that question, Byron, but there's so much noise going at my house right now.
It's just getting worse. You can hear it now. Dang, I was hoping you were gonna get that, Zelrog. It looked like you had it there. You had the opportunity for it. Oh, no thanks. You can just skip me. I'm not taking a win today. First time was a fluke. Well, heck, I didn't even win. I just got 2 stocks. Beat your Diddy 2 out of 3. That was your day one, Diddy. But you're right. Those were wins. But I meant against Mac. I could try switching to DK. Maybe I'll be able to do something. Anyway, Byron, you asked what game franchise do I want to see an adaptation of to animation? I think a lot of people want a Zelda movie or a Zelda series, and I definitely agree. I think that there's opportunity for something nice there. I don't know what kind it would be, but I think that there's opportunity there for a good series. But other games, I would like to see a Psychonauts cartoon. I think Psychonauts would work really well as a cartoon. See you later, Duplo. Remember when someone joked about an Awesomenauts TV show? I'm sure that's happened a few times over the course of the game's life. Oh, thanks, Duplo. Oh, so Iron Mac won that last match? I didn't even realize. I thought Duplo had that. He had all the others. Let me think. What other shows would make a great cartoon, now that I think about it? Maybe Final Fantasy? I could see a Final Fantasy show working. They've had a movie or two, didn't they? But they were all based on Final Fantasy VII, so maybe something new. Oh, there it is. Should have camped. Can Bowser do that? Anyone can. Are you sure? Because I've said something to the effect of, oh, I should have tried camping more. And then, you know, I've been told basically I can't. Oh, of course. Gambit just means not approaching, which you can against any opponent who can't force an approach by damaging you from afar.
Wait, hold on. How come my throw didn't remove KO punch?
Just like old times, huh?
I went for that risky grab because I was trying to just get rid of KO punch. Guess it didn't deal enough damage. It's not based on damage, it's based on knockback. Throws absolutely remove KO punch. As long as he receives knockback, KO punch goes away. I've thrown to remove KO punch before.
If it was based on knockbacks, then suplex wouldn't remove it so well.
It's any knockback, like any at all. He has to be sent in tumble for him to lose it. Oh, tumble. Excuse me. Ah! You have to wait 4 seconds before you can do that. So if I did it too fast after him getting it, it doesn't do it. Oh, I guess they wanted to leave. I can see that Iron Mac is still here. The Mario, yeah, I saw that. This is so embarrassing. No, I... What? I was behind him! Why? Oh my gosh, he didn't do the thing! He always rolls behind me.
Man, this practice is... my practicing is not helping me. DK is good, good. It's... I know... Okay, look. I'm gonna be real, real with you guys. I want to know how. How are my characters good? Like, how? How? Because if they were good, I would be winning with them. But it's not good enough because I'm not winning. And it's not like I'm playing against somebody with a new strategy I've never seen before. These are mostly people I've played with before. And I... Ooh, Switch was being annoying. Hello there, King Derp-a-Derp. But no, for real, like, how? How is it good? I am failing, like, sometimes spectacularly. And there are gigantic holes in my games, my gameplay. I mean, I don't mean to be overly negative, but I also don't want to lie to myself and say that it's good, because it's just not. You saw the same match I played. You saw those moves I made. What's the arena ID? Oh, there's a command for it. Just type exclamation point arena. We got plenty of space. There it is. I was waiting for that. Been trying something out. Ooh, what are you working on, Derp-a-Derp? I'm very curious. Oh. Oh. This is a very strange maneuver. And that's, I mean, that's not me. He has my name, but that's not me. Your Bowser is extremely clean, and I'm a little surprised you don't play him more often. I'm convinced every Mii, Swordy, and Zelda player online conspires with each other because I hardly see any of them use moves besides specials. There was that one Zelda who used to hang around with us a while. He would often use all of his moves. He was also really good. I wish that move didn't hit so low. Like, pick a direction to go, please. Well, I got lucky with him not teching it. Oh! Misinput.
Clean.
Were you trying to go for a down B spike? He might have been. I think he was just trying to catch me in general. I don't know, it usually works. I lose to his Bowser more than I beat it.
Three, two, one, go!
Oh. I used my jump. I didn't hit the floor. Got him with the reverse.
Thank you.
Oh, well, this is it. Yeah, it's over. I'm very good at predicting when I'm going to lose. If only I could use that power of prediction for what my opponent is going to do. Yeah, I was, but, you know, close only matters in horseshoes and hand grenades. Gotta do laundry. Ah! Laundry. I usually wait way too long to do laundry myself. When that when that laundry bag is packed full, then I'm like, okay, I guess I'll do laundry. Wait till you have nothing to wear, then you do it. Oh, there it is, yeah. I don't really like watching streams on YouTube. I don't know what it is about their encoding or something, but their delay is just really long compared to others. College didn't use them. You've never used liquid detergent before you went to college? What'd you use, powder? Oh, you used Tide Pods. Hmm. Was what set ultra low latency on YouTube, and even then it's not amazing, you know. Right in the face. Switch. You think so?
Well, I assume you're still talking about the liquid detergent, but
I've only ever used liquid detergent. I assume using a pod is easy. You just... So, wait, actually, I've never used those sorts of things. Do you just toss it inside the washing machine and then that's it? Or do you put it inside the cup where you put the liquid detergent? Man, also, have you seen those Tide Pod boxes nowadays? Ever since that fiasco with the eating Tide Pods meme,
they've had bigger and bigger warnings to not eat them on the package. Now, like, half of the front of the box is just telling you don't eat the thing. Game.
No contest.
Okay. Mac quit. No, I think it's more like Mac disconnected. Tide Pod Pizza is the future. Ah, delicious. Mmm, bleach cleaning products in my mouth. Well, good job, Lank. You saved Hyrule. Lawyers are sweating on the graphic design department. I really feel it cleaning my innards. Mmm, delicious. Put it the... It pops in your mouth just like a gusher! Well, I'm glad that Nick managed to get a stock off of you. Oh jeez, it's 2 weeks until Super Mario Bros. Wonder. Hey, guys, I need to ask, where am I going? So, with 2 weeks left until Super Mario Bros. Wonder, I am opening up, I don't know if I'd call them emergency commissions, but I'm opening up commissions. You know those portraits I do on the weekends of Toons? I'll do one of those of your OC or whatever character you want, right? $40 a pop, because I want to buy Super Mario Wonder. And another fan was gracious enough to help me to donate. To donate for, some Super Mario, was gracious enough to donate, but I would, love to, oh my gosh, Rora, hello, it's good to see you, and also, hello, your boy Jeff, but yes, I have these commissions open, and I would really appreciate if you guys would buy some, because I want to buy Super Mario Bros. Wonder when it comes out. It's been a minute, how you doing? Oh, it's Smash Friday. I'm doing... okay. Okay, I'll take it. Oh.
Okay. Oh, I thought he was... So when he said you can use the side special after the up special, I thought he was talking about... me, Sword Fighter, and I'm like, I'm pretty sure that's not the case. But he was actually talking about Sora. Goodness, man, I'm hungry. I've suddenly become hungry. Chat, best pizza topping, go. Wait a minute, I have some fried rice waiting for me in the fridge. I can eat that. Meat lovers. What kind of meat lovers? So it's like sausage, bacon, ham. Parmesan cheese, huh? I like sausage. That's my personal favorite. Okay, I definitely should not have been spiked there. What? What? I was definitely under the stage and should have grabbed. It hurts. It hurts so much. Did that two frame? I don't know. It might have. I don't think it goes low enough to two frame. I probably was just above it. Oh, goodness. Well, you know what? I'm starting to think that I should just go into it being like, yeah, I'm bad. So what? You don't even know who you picked. So you didn't...
Did you pick random, or did you, like... Hello, Lara Cross. Hi, Mars. Who... Where's Mars? You know, the funny thing is that people are like, oh, just to let go is to rediscover enjoyment sometimes.
True.
If I could just... If I was somebody who was good enough to just be annoying, I would probably try to do that, but I can't do that. All this training and stuff has not... has not brought me success. Speaking from experience. Yes, it can be difficult. Last time I did was with one of Fate's friends. Fate's friends? Huh. Trying to remember. Cry. I thought you were saying Fate had a friend named Terry. I was like, who's Terry? I know who Fate is. I'm collabing with him on Monday. Splat Bree. Okay. Oh, I guess I should say, yeah, I'm collabing with Fate on Monday. We're gonna be doing Super Mario World. I know, it's not a spooky game, but... Heh, we like Super Mario World. Be warned? Be warned. What are we warning about? His chat has gotten extra dirty lately. I don't know if I'll be able to even see his chat. I'll have to figure out my setup for that. Well, it's just gonna be me and him. Oof. So I'm taking a 2-month break from Splatoon. I can't wait to get way too salty again, only to break to the other side of, it doesn't matter, just try to have a good time separate from women. And then my win-loss ratio goes back into the positive as a result. Like I said, speaking from experience. Strange, why did it send that, both of those message all at once at the same time? Did you guys see that somebody modded Sonic Frontiers to turn all of Amy's cards into Yu-Gi-Oh cards? I cut paste a longer message to avoid getting cut up. Oh, I see. They modded Amy's cards to be Yu-Gi-Oh cards and gave her the card deck thing. Duel? We're gonna duel splat. We're gonna duel dapples.
I can't believe it. Another DDD main out in the wild.
Yeah, Martian's been here for a while, Derper Derp. And I know you've been here before. Just try to have a good time and not worry about it. I suppose that works a lot better if you are good at the game. Yeah, but it's a little harder to try to turn your brain off and have fun if you're not good. Guess you just remember duel and duel are different words. You have a reflector. Does reflector block Gordos? I guess it would, huh? But I don't know if it's gonna, I mean, it is frame one, so it might work. He'll just hit them back. Well, you still have Reflector if he does that.
Three, two, one, go!
Although I don't know. So normally when you do have reflectors hitting an hitting something back and forth, eventually the reflector will break. But I don't know if that really works the same way for DDD. Not to mention that the Gordo does eventually disappear. Although I wonder if it only disappears, if it disappears on a timer or only, or like if you can extend it by hitting it more. I'd love to see DDD fail to recover once in a while, but it's so rare. I do think it might be easier to have a little fun when you do have things outside of the direct confrontations. Yeah, like if you got like a, if you can do like a side mode or something, maybe doing doubles. I mean, a fighting game. It's just you and the opponent, and the stage, and everyone else who's watching, and the items, and Nana. Hello, Kawaii. Welcome, welcome. Fire. Huh? Strange for somebody to come in and say welcome. I just play a supportive position where I focus on territory control or something. I don't know what I do with a fighting game. Yeah. A game that's probably like that perfect mix for me is TF2. Kinda no matter what, I can have a good time in TF2. And I can definitely decide to goof off if I want to. Your playing style, you play a mean Zangief in Street Fighter. I actually like Chun-Li. But I don't like no combos or anything. I can't play traditional fighters. There's too much to pay attention to. They're way harder to learn than this. Isn't Smash like that? No. Smash is different. The inputs across all characters are the same. You do the down special for one character, you can do the down special for every character. It's all the same. That's also why I can't play Ryu or Ken. I can't do motion inputs. Like, it's very intuitive. I want to attack to the left. So I point the stick in the left direction and press A, you know?
Gotta put your stuff into the dryer. Alright, I'll take it. I'm very appreciative of simple input schemes. Yeah, it puts a lot of the stress of trying to learn how the game functions out of my head. No. I don't know how. Yeah, see? How am I supposed to just forget it and have fun when I wasn't allowed to push any buttons for at least 10 seconds? All I had to do was just wait as he got me into a combo I couldn't escape from. The only thing I could do was just wiggle the stick and hope I got out of it. Trying to wait and look for the opportunity to attack is such a hassle. Cause some characters get it for free, like Mario being able to toss a fireball means that interaction has happened and I haven't even gotten the chance to get close yet. While I have to commit to going all the way in. Also, he recovers from that? How high does that move go? He was off stage the screen. The
Maybe I would play Street Fighter if they had Smash-esque inputs. Because that way, it gets me past the part of trying to worry about whether or not I can even input the move in the first place, and I can start thinking about the move itself and what I want to do. Six duds. Yes, but you are at a disadvantage for doing so, so you're better off just not. Like, the game would have to be designed from the ground up in order for it to be worth it. Introducing modern controls to Street Fighter 6, also giving you a disadvantage by making them weaker, means that they're not optimal and you should just use the regular inputs anyway. For what it's worth, though, I did play the Street Fighter 6 demo with friends, and I had a decent time. Half the players you play against use modern. Well, as you go up in the ranks, you see modern less. Come on, Conker. You know you got it in you to get one. Ooh, you almost had it. I don't know if using reflector is the play, but you've got it. There's in there for you to get one. You gotta start using some quicker moves. Those laggy maneuvers are really kicking your butt now. Oh, he's not done with the dryer!
Three, two, one, go!
But to answer your question about how I came back and let you fight in K-Rule, Mario's a very good linear recovery.
No, I know. It's not so much how did he do that, like, that shouldn't happen, that's impossible, but more like, how did he do that, as in, like, why is Mario allowed to do that?
Oh, shield poking.
Should have seen that one coming. I'm constantly shocked at how janky Mario is sometimes. Rock Manxel. Toon Link. Uh-oh. Okay, glad I turned that around. Wow, I used my jump already. I can't believe it. All that, and then he just does one of those? I don't know. It felt like it was just like wiping his face across the controller. Except for those very, very niche scenarios where he would do one or two combos, but it always happened to be at the worst moments, so like when I was at high percent. Meanwhile, the rest of the time he just kind of presses buttons. Trying to figure out how to stop Link from pressing buttons is hard though. I was just looking for an opening in his defense there, but after the first two stocks, he just kept throwing bombs and arrows and stuff, and it was over. Hello, Pencil. First one down. Play Toon Link in Brawl just because Young Link wasn't a thing. Well, you don't play Young Link, do you? Wait, I don't remember you playing Young Link too much. T-Link is not easy for heavyweights. What sucks though is that guy totally had me booked He had me down, and I can't do that. Wait a minute, hold on. I looked away for a minute, and I came back to finding that Kazuya totally just beat him.
Apparently Kazuya hates Toon Links, can't blame him. I don't normally have a huge issue with Toon Links. The only issue I really have is when I'm in the air and trying to land, and I need to find somewhere to go. Ladder combos are dumb. I mean, yeah, but that's like how Mario works, right? I mean, well, Conker, you know, a lot of the things that I've heard you have problems with are things that you could figure out how to do with practice. Like movement and your combos, just a general feel for how your character works so that you're comfortable in your skin when you're playing them. Those are all things that come with consistent, intentional practice. Understanding how combos work, understanding how to escape combos, you could at least read up what you should do if you don't know.
It's, I'm not talking specifically just about this particular instance. Maybe you can get something good with Pac-Man. You good at Pac-Man's combos?
He's hard, Pac-Man.
He's difficult to really wrap my head around. That's why I play characters like DK. They have basic game plans. Problem with a basic game plan, though, is that anybody with anything more complex is just gonna demolish me. I really do wish I had it. I really do wish I had it. Like, you know, it. The thing that makes good people good. Whatever it is. I don't know if the water is gonna really, I don't know if Flood's really gonna help you all that much. Cause I see you use it, but DDD can kinda just ignore. Rather have fun than play a character I dislike, but I'm good at. Well, how do you have any characters that you dislike, but you're good at? Which characters are you good with but don't like?
Link. Why? What's wrong? Like, I never... I mean, I guess I've never seen you play it. But not Link in this game. I see. Link in 4. Remember when Korn was just Smash 4 main? Because of the game she's from, I hate her. I hate her so much. You know, people, I think people forget that male Korin's even a thing. Yeah, no, it must be the wind. Look, I always pick girl, always. No, but it's not just you, Tinny. No one cares about male Korin. In fact, the male is the default for all the other characters, except for Korin. Robin, Byleth, male default. Kirby male default? Kirby is not a male. Kirby is a creature. No one should care about corn, period. A slice of white bread has more personality and complexity to it. You're right, people should care about Camilla. At least Femcorn is pretty. Yeah, but how come, like, when they're in war, they got, like, their feetsies out? Why aren't they wearing any shoes? They're in battle, right? Yes, usually Kirby's called he, him. In the manual for Dreamland, he's called a boy. Fate's characters are bad, and I will say it with your whole chest. I say things with my mouth. Ice cold pig. True, it's not very controversial to say that Fate's isn't the best.
I don't know how people can see me do something like that and then tell me I'm good. I mean, the data doesn't lie. I'm getting my butt kicked out here. Never say why Corrin doesn't wear shoes. I think the reason is because they have to have the... Think I could be a good clown? I don't know. I've never, I don't know what your routine is. Yeah, I get it. Enjoyed Three Houses, but I still haven't finished Three Houses. Let me tell you what was exhausting about Three Houses. After every single battle, I think I just like got to like the first battle you do when there's those thieves at the bridge, right? I like the first real battle of the game or something. Let me tell you, having to constantly go back to the monastery to like check up on everyone before I you know, if I wanted to like do well, you have to do that. What was I saying? Oh yeah. Like, in order to do well at that game, you gotta spend a lot of time doing social stuff, and that is a lot of micromanagement. Made Fire Emblem and Persona combined. True. Only the Fire Emblem I play is Warriors. Hmm. Awakening is usually considered to be a very good one. Supports have always been part of Fire Emblem? Not always. I don't believe there were any supports in the first two. Or at least the first three. Definitely not until they got to, like, the Game Boy. My aforementioned Fire Emblem friend has begged me to play Three Houses. She swears I will like the story in it. Well, the story you get also depends on which of the people you pick. Like, you have the choice between the band kids, the rich preppy kids, or fascists.
Most people pick the band kids.
You're not wrong with how you describe the houses.
Yeah.
I started with Awakening, really liked it, and hated Fates enough to skip the widely agreed upon really good one.
Are you interested in Engage at all?
Until Fire Emblem Warriors Engage.
Tomorrow. Comes out tomorrow. Golden Deer is best house. Yes, most people will tell you that.
I look at Engage and feel anger stir inside of me.
What? Why? That's not a reaction I expected. Fire Emblem Engage makes my blood boil.
Like Colgate.
What's wrong with Pepsi? The character designs are hot garbage and Engage, and it's not just the pro tag. Oh? Did they change? Is it like... They didn't change the design of the old characters much, did they?
Pokemon Stadium 1 today?
Yeah, but we like PS1.
See a lot of Effie Fates in Engage.
Ah. He just blew himself up. Love it.
Yes, does give me different vibes and I'm curious about trying it at some point.
Hmm.
Wow, look at all that.
Now I get it why he's called Gouda. He's going for the cheese.
Everyone hates Lucina.
What? I don't think people hate Lucina. Maybe in Smash some people do. She's got an interesting character arc. And her, like, gimmick of pretending to be Marth is pretty cool.
Effie Friend says, if you're gonna play it once, play Blue Lion. That's the best story by far.
I like the Golden Deer. But I also didn't get very far.
Asking since I thought she was in Fates. Why would Lucina be in Fates? Blue Blue Lion does have the best story. Oh, well, there's another person saying Blue Lion has the best story. Thought it was sequel. No. It's very rare you'll get a Fire Emblem that's a direct sequel to another one. The only one I can think of off the top of my head is the two with Marth, 1 and 3, and then the two with Roy and his father. That is a drone. It's true. It's a drone strike. Also the ones with Ike. Oh, yeah. Ike. I thought it said also the ones with Like, and I thought you were going to explain, but yeah. FEHS. FE High School? If they're Fire Emblem High School, Marth and Sheeta are definitely prom king and queen, alright? They're definitely gonna be that annoying couple that everybody knows, and they're like, yeah, they're basically made for each other. It's actually kind of funny how sad Marth gets in FE1, like, in general, but then he gets even sadder if you let Sheeta die. High School Tokyo Mirage Sessions. That game barely counts as Fire Emblem. Like, it's barely a crossover. Is Thrasia 776 a sequel? I don't know. But I love that Thrasia 776 has Tharja and... Right, is that the one Tharja's from? No, excuse me. I don't know why I thought she was. Oh, it's got the Final Fantasy thing where you can pick any one of them and not worry about it. Mm. Anyway, no, excuse me, she was from Awakening. I don't know why I thought Tharja was 776. Anyway, I love that Tharja is like an important character, and they keep, but Smash keeps having to censor her. I mean, I guess I don't blame them. Like, what is that outfit? She's wearing pantyhose over her entire body. And she's just got a bikini over the pantyhose. So every time they have her in five, so she was going to get a trophy in Smash 4, but then the ESRB was like, nuh-uh. And then they were also, and then her spirit artwork in Smash is not her artwork from, like, the game. It's a cropped picture of her in-game talking sprite.
excuse me, I didn't mean to yawn so loudly, but I can't. Hey, how about Xenoblade? Any of you guys played Xenoblade? I have Xenoblade 1, and I didn't get very far in it. I think I got to, like, Bionis' leg or something. I'm curious about that one. Like, how did that how did the first game turn from such like an earnest RPG story into a waifu collector in the sequel? I've played Xenoblade 1. The shift in tone and direction kept you from playing 2, and not playing 2 is keeping you from playing 3. 3, as far as I know, the only thing that as far as I'm aware, the thing that would get me to play 3 is Uni. Upsets me too much as I deem anime nonsense. See, as you know, it too is weird. I could say that as someone who's fully gone through that entire game. Oh, yeah? Type that because you figured it'd be fine. Yeah, it's fine. I don't mind if you guys swear in chat or make reference to swearing in chat. Man, Smash is so much more fun when you get to win. I was definitely behind him. Mm. Yeah, see, that right there, not so fun.
But if over half the cast gives survival, pay $60 to ogle these women. It turns me off. I'm a certified woman enjoyer, but pandering annoys me to no end.
Yeah! Why would I pay $60 to ogle women when I... when I have the Sears catalog?
Oh my gosh. You love Zeke from that game. Shan, please. I am a respectful lesbian. Any Pretty Cure fan here? Sorry, only Ugly Cure. I have never watched a single Magical Girl anime. The closest I got was I watched a few episodes of... I watched a few episodes of Cardcaptor and some Kill la Kill. And, did I see anything else? I saw Pop Team Epic. That had some. Like Sailor Moon meets DBZ. Mm-hmm. I've only seen DBZ abridged. Never really watched Sailor Moon. I think I saw one or two episodes of Sailor Moon now that you mention it. I was kind of bored. Mostly because it was kind of a lot of standing around and talking. And, like, it's funny because I love shows that are standing around and talking. Like, I loved Azumanga Daioh and K-On. That's Toei for you. That's not Toei. I've seen parts of Puss in Boots. That was definitely not that. Heck, I've seen Koneko no Rakugaki. It's a movie. Pretty Cure's not a movie. Unless you're talking about Puss in Boots. I know Puss in Boots is a movie. It's like their movie. He's in their, you know. Pretty Cure is a series of movies. Yes, that's true. Yes, 100%, Octo. I get it. I'm familiar with Pretty Cure as, like, a thing. Somebody else has to agree with me that Kill la Kill counts as a Magical Girl show, right? Start with the original Heart Catch if you want. If I ever get around to it, I probably would watch the original. Counts as a skimpy girl action show. Oh yes, all those.
Oh gosh. This is the, what movie did I just get out of in the middle of the 90s that has the ballad remix of the original theme from the film? I don't know enough the definition to qualify what isn't. Is Owl House a magical girl show? No. No, because they don't, like, transform or anything. I think the crux of magical girls is that they have to, like, transform. Like, the main cast has to be mostly, if not entirely, girls. And they have, like, magical abilities granted to them. And they transform. As a girl who does magic. That is true. Mascot's not necessarily required. What more do I want? I want a sandwich. I'd like a big, you know what? I'd like a panini with chicken and Monterey Jack. And a side of onion rings. Goodness gracious, this song is putting me to sleep. Oh my gosh. That's better. Alright, chat. What's the best... When you get your chicken... When you get cheese with your chicken, sandwiches or paninis or wraps or whatever, what cheese... do you like with it? I generally go, for me, kind of depends, but I prefer provolone. Yellow. No cheese. Well, lots of cheeses are yellow. Cheddar. I like provolone. I had Gruyere once. Gruyere was pretty tasty. Mozzarella on a chicken parm sandwich is pretty tasty. So no talk about Twitter. Huh? What do you mean, no talk about Twitter? Did anyone talk about Twitter? Provolone, but I'm also lactose intolerant, so I'm stuck lying down for a bit because my stomach disagrees. It's X now, right? It is. It's X Twitter. Huh. Like Kamen Rider. No, I mean X as in formerly Twitter. Did he quit? Oh my gosh, he quit! What the heck? Wow. That sucks. But at least you didn't get sent to the back. Oh, hey, Brian Tran. I remember them.
He didn't like fighting Martian DDD. Most people don't. I'm in your game and I haven't played in a minute, so I'm gonna be kind of rusty at the game. That's okay, I suck. Dead naming is bad form, but we can make one exception for Twitter. We will. We dead name Twitter in this household. Yeah, I think Joe Hisaishi music's gonna get me. Not sure though. Hisaishi. Joe Hisaishi. Wait, what did he do? Oh, this guy does all the Ghibli movies. Yeah, no, I can't put that one in there. I'm gonna get got. Yes, but Joe Hisaishi is the guy who made the song. Did not know that. Yeah, it depends on who. Most game music is tends to be fine. These DDDs are just sucking in mid. Catch me streaming Cage Melody and Memories and getting 39 copy strikes. Ugh, I know, do I stream that game or not? Because that game is canon. No Kamen Rider fans here. Never seen Kamen Rider in my life. I'll take it. You're kidding me. How come that didn't work? That Japanese McDonald's ad is based. The one with the lesbian werewolf, or the one with the family? The family one. I mean, I suppose. What wolf? They posted another one with a bunch of monsters in it, and there was this girl werewolf that, like, shared a french fry with the other girl in the car. Lesbian werewolf, yeah! Hey, what happened to my giant punch? Why didn't that hit? He fell right through it. Yeah, hang on, hold on. Let me get it. Just a second. You don't watch much about anime? Much about anime? Why don't you ever move forward with the up B when you miss? Huh? Because if I move forward, that makes it easier for somebody to get me? I mean, what am I? I'm using Spinning Kong already. Any easier than staying within arm's reach? Yeah, I don't know. It's a little, they have to do just a little bit more work. They have to do just a little bit more work to get close to me. If I don't approach when I'm using Spinning Kong, and that has gotten me to avoid getting hit. But like, if I just attack your shield, that doesn't do anything. I don't know. I wouldn't have to be in that situation if I just hit it normally anyways. Doesn't really matter anyways. It's not like I was gonna win if I... It's not like I was really gonna win in the first place. Let's be real here. Where the heck is it? I can't find the ad. Can't wait for Persona 6.
I haven't, so pardon me, I was looking for the tweet. The only thing I can find out about the tweet is, like, I can't find the tweet itself. And it's just people being mad about it. And, like, I'm looking in the comments and, like, that people hate the nuclear family. And I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm like, who are you people? Like, they hate the nuclear family. They're like, what are you guys talking about? Who's getting mad about a mom and a dad and their kid going to McDonald's? Like, there is this, like, manufactured outrage about it, and I don't even get it. I don't even know where people got the idea that, like, they were hating it for having a nuclear family in it. Don't want to get political? No politics, right? Is it political to say it's fine? How'd you lose your jump? You probably jumped before you got inhaled. Okay, I wasn't gonna talk about it. Yeah, the controversy around the McD's ad was so funny. It was! I don't even get it! I'm like, where did this come from? Why are they defending it as some paragon of normalcy? Mega Man guy was your first guy. Oh, well then you should have stopped with him. He left. Did you fight this guy already? A whole crowd of people pretending that other people were mad. That's what it was! And I was so confused by it. I'm like, what the heck are you talking about? Of what? See ya, Octosquidus. See, they're talking about this McDonald's ad that was a little animation of a mom, a dad, and their kid eating some fries. It, like, got really viral. I mean, it's a very cute ad and all. You know, it's the little kid, like, just having some fries with the mom and dad, and it's all very cute. Twitter, so what else is new? I saw some hate. Kind of wish I didn't, but yeah. Failed. Were you the Bayonetta Spiky Kyle? Don't worry about it. We all suck here. It's like when the clown in It, right, Pennywise, he's talking to the kid in the gutter, and he's like, oh yes, Johnny, we all suck down here. We all suck at video games. suck at video games, I mean. Oh gosh.
You guys gonna go?
Oh, thank you, Spiky Kyle. Oh, they were waiting for them to get in line so they could watch. Ah. Oh, geez, sorry, my voice was so off. Wait, not like that. That's a very pretty looking Shantae. You know, I'm realizing just in a case of pure numbers, there were probably way more requests for characters from players in America than anywhere else. Well, okay, actually Europe, probably. Like, there's no way that the Japan region had more players voting for the characters they wanted than America or Europe. You know? I wish they would show us the numbers, but they're never going to. But, like, I really want to know how many votes Sora actually got in comparison to everyone else. In hindsight, it's really funny that they tried to convince us that Bayonetta was the most requested character. Like, in Europe? Well, I mean, I guess I could still believe that, but I'm a little shocked that, you know, they would like, oh yeah, she's the most of, she's the character with the most votes overall. Character from Yo-Kai Watch. You never struck me as a Yo-Kai Watch fan. Probably a bunch, but because Square said they just said no, so they said, yeah, Bayo gets in. Well, Bayo would have been much easier, and also not as big of a request as characters like Ridley or K. Rool. He uses the power of friendship and light to skew the votes in his favor. True. He loved the Yo-Kai Watch growing up. I remember hearing about the Yo-Kai Watch games as they came out, and then in America, the series just kind of died. Elsewhere, in Japan, I should say, they're still going strong, but in the US, they just died. I think people just really didn't care for it because it wasn't Pokemon. I remember watching for 8 hours a day. I was sick while eating. 8 hours on a day I was sick. I thought, 8 hours a day? I'm like, that's a full-time job watching Yo-Kai Watch. Don't know why I remember, but I ate 24 and a half popsicles. Why'd you stop with the half one? Because I didn't like the flavor of it. Fantastic. So I threw it away. Broski. You could have, like, melted it and then mixed it with other popsicles. in the... Okay. You're telling me that Game & Watch's up special is fast enough that he can use it while I'm in the middle of using Spinning Kong on him? Just jumps all over the place and keeps juggling. I don't get it. There has to be a solution to it, because the solution shouldn't be just find a different character to play. Alright, we got enough time for one or maybe two more matches. You know, people say, don't worry about it, just have fun, right? Then you have a match like that. Oh, I'm sorry. What? I'm supposed to have fun? I'm supposed to have fun while being comboed like that, and I have no chance of reacting to it? I want to see if he's the real one. You can hit him up later. I don't know who Elegant is, so as far as I'm concerned, there's no skin off my back. Number one Luigi in the world. Why would he be here? I suck. Why would he come here? Not gonna get any interesting matches against me, that's for sure. He was the number one Luigi before he got banned. What did he get banned for? Alcohol. Oh. Next Smash, I want them to change Game & Watch's and Sonic's down smash so that they can't use their up specials out of it. You gotta commit to that move now. You gotta actually think about using it instead of just using it whenever. Alright, I got time for one more. Why is Game & Watch unpunishable? His up special is frame 3 invincibility.
Oh, they left.
Frame 2.
Looks like a bunch of people were also there just to see Elegant play.
I mean, since they all left together.
I just left because this was the last match.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if Martian can pull off one more, because this Game & Watch is not giving anybody any time. Big hit. Ooh, right, but then that hitbox is nasty. Oh, he didn't get sucked in. I see. Well, certainly was quick. Well. That's the last match of the day, fellas. We had some tough battles, some fun battles, some battles that were just kind of total farces, but that's fine. Ah, well. So, tomorrow is the art streams, and you voted for your favorite Toon Witch, which is great. Keep in mind, I also have my commissions open for those of you who would like some art, $40 a pop of your OC in my Toon portrait style. You can see it right over here. How much for a colored sketch? Well, for yours, I only did a sketch because of the number of characters that were in it. If you want just like one or two characters, I'll do a colored cleanup sketch. How much to color a sketch I already made? If you want me to color the one I already made for you, I'll do it for $15. But if you guys want any art of yourself in these styles, they're $40 a pop. I am saving up to buy Super Mario Brothers Wonder, so I would appreciate it if you guys would be interested in buying. After the art streams tomorrow and Sunday, on Monday, I will be streaming Super Mario World with a friend. So that should be great. I hope you guys will be there for that. All right, I'll see you guys later. Have yourselves a very good night, and goodbye.